More than 2 months after the riot at the U.S. Capitol, the country remains on high alert for violence from homegrown terrorists, we are told. Our intelligence committee warns that the threat is at an all-time high and is still growing.
That's prompted calls for a new federal law specifically targeting domestic terrorism. National investigative correspondent Josie Sturman explains in tonight's Spotlight on America.
These are Americans. Look at the flag.
It was an attack on the U.S. Capitol, but the long arm of the law has extended well beyond Washington, D.C. since January 6th.
One of the most widely seen videos from the siege on the Capitol, said to show a Rochester man.
The FBI has zeroed in on a Mobile woman.
Two Arkansas men who are now behind bars.
According to George Washington University's program on extremism, which is tracking cases related to the insurrection, at least 270 people have been charged in federal court. That includes 241 men and 38 women from 40 states, with the highest numbers coming from Florida, New York, Pennsylvania, and Texas. Their alleged crimes range from trespassing to conspiracy, but there's one charge you won't find against any Capitol rioter: domestic terrorism, because it doesn't exist.
We have the odd situation, whereas if you engage in certain conduct outside of our borders, it's a federal crime, but you do the same conduct inside our borders, and it's not considered terrorism.
David Schanzer is the director of the Triangle Center on Terrorism and Homeland Security at Duke University. He says a federal law is needed to deal with the growing white supremacist movement and to distinguish between valid protests and planned political conspiracies to commit violence.
So we've seen these ideas gaining prominence, people being more and more willing to engage in violence over the last couple decades.
About a third of the building has been blown away.
It's been a concern since the Oklahoma City bombing in 1995. Following that attack, congressional lawmakers first proposed the idea of a domestic terrorism statute. 25 years later, though, still no specific law, but plenty of debate.
The reality is law enforcement agencies already have all the authority they need to address white supremacist violence.
Manar Wahid, an attorney with the ACLU, says the feds have more than 50 domestic terrorism-related crimes they can use to investigate and prosecute, as well as hate crime statutes. And there's concern a new domestic terrorism law designed to curb white extremism could actually result in further over-policing of black and brown communities.
So we see this used over and over again in ways that violate equal protection, due process, First Amendment rights. Giving law enforcement agencies more police powers or more crimes is actually not going to address the problem. I think it will absolutely do harm.
As Congress argues whether a new law would harm or help, hundreds of Capitol cases are pending in court, with the FBI still on the hunt for other suspects. Experts agree the agency needs more resources to identify extremist threats within our borders, no matter what charge ultimately lands them in court. I'm Josie Sturman for Spotlight on America.
Is there a story you think we should investigate? Call our Eyewitness News tip line at 869-2929.